Hey, yo, Bo. Hey. Can I give you a lift over to Serenity Springs? I'm sure the party's still going on.
No, thanks. I'm going to be celebrating here tonight, Ben.
Our hospital room isn't exactly party central.
Well, it is when Nora's here, and she's going to be okay. I want to be the first thing she sees when she opens those beautiful eyes.
Well, that might not happen till morning.
I don't care. I'm not going to miss it.
After what you've both been through, I'd say that's a good call.
Hey, Ben. If it hadn't been for you, we really wouldn't be celebrating anything. Thank you. That sounds pretty hollow. I mean, thanks isn't enough for everything you've done for us.
No, it was my job and my pleasure. Happy New Year, Bo.
Happy New Year.
I'm sorry, no visitors.
I'm not a visitor.
Detective Manzo, what are you doing here?
Well, I was checking on the officer I've got posted downstairs. I figured I'd come up and see how Miss Gannon was doing.
She's coming through with flying colors. You've got a cop downstairs.
Just in case Todd Manning tries to come back and finish what he started at the beach house.
Eyes, take a look for yourself. No? That's okay. That's okay. You keep sleeping. It'll be good for you. Give me a chance to spruce up this room a little bit, you know? Ben's right. Hospital rooms are about as cheery as a broom closet. I don't know why they don't use more color in here. That's it. That is it. Listen. I'm gonna go out for a second, all right? Don't you wake up until I get back.
Excuse me, sir. That is one gray tie. I'll give you $10 for it. No, I haven't been drinking. This is about love, pal. $30.
To celebrate the new year, JCPenney announced...
...to designer coffee on Good Morning America Sunday.
Really me, and we're both in heaven, Angel. Take a look at this. Huh? Can you see me?
Huh?
Happy New Year. What is this?
It's a glass, bow.
Please be more specific, Ms. Gannon.
It's an ugly glass. It's an ugly hospital glass. Blue, acrylic or plastic of some kind. It's kind of a weird little ship bow. I can see, you know, there's no sense in keep going through all these ridiculous, the toothbrush, magazine. See? And read the magazine if you wanted me to, Candy. The most handsome face in the whole universe.
She can see.
I told you I can see. But unfortunately, no bizarre test in the world that you could possibly give me is going to say anything until Dr. Price and Dr. Dowling get here and let us know if the surgery was successful or not.
Don't be so pessimistic.
I'm being realistic.
Well, think positive.
It's not my nature.
Well, then, fake it.
Ben.
Hey, how you doing, Bo? And how are your eyes feeling?
Never better. Did you get the results in the lab tests?
Well, they should be coming up any minute now. Look at that special delivery.
So how you doing?
I don't know. Ask your brother.
To whom?
To someone who will help me. Well?
It's not often I get to say this, but the operation was a complete success.
Thank God. Yes.
That's what you said the last time.
You're being pessimistic again.
Actually, that's not what I said last time. If you recall, I was extremely cautious about any prognosis.
Yeah, Dr. Dowling was the one with all the empty promises.
There. Satisfying?
Yeah.
Yeah. Dave, Buchanan, hey, I got that starch white coat image to maintain. You mind?
No, I don't mind. Thanks. Thank you, Ben.
Well, don't thank me. I wish. Well, I should have told you the possible risks after your first surgery. I'm sorry, Nora.
Oh, don't apologize. I'm just grateful that we've got good results this time, you know? And besides, I know why you didn't say anything.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Dr. Dowling's the big shot, and you're just a lowly resident, chain of command.
Well, I'll take the fifth on that. Besides, that was no excuse for keeping quiet.
Yeah, but Nora's right. We're just glad that you took the lead this time because you did the job that nobody thought was going to be easy. And now Nora is going to be just fine. The nightmare is over.
No.
What?
The nightmare's not going to be over until Todd Manning's back in prison.
I don't understand.
You spend the night with me.
General Hospital.
Well, you must feel like a million bucks.
Not yet.
I feel like a million bucks.
Me too.
Now, don't you ever put us through anything like that ever again.
Okay, fine with me.
Do you think Ben will come by? I wanted to thank him. Ooh, that might mean we have to listen to more of his bad jokes.
Ben has been here and gone already.
Oh. Well, I'm going to go find him.
I love you. I know you too, baby.
Beautiful.
Any news on Todd?
No, not yet. But listen, Nora, when you're feeling up to it, I'd like to talk to you about what happened at the beach house with Todd Manning. I mean, anything that you might be able to remember.
Well, let's do it right now.
Okay. But not a full statement, okay? I'm not sure if you have the strength for it. But anything that you know that could help with this investigation?
Well, I told you the important thing. He's going to need a doctor.
Yeah. You know you're an amazing woman?
Well, it's kind of hard to believe I actually stabbed a guy, but I did with my sewing shears. Somewhere in the upper portion of the body.
It's right up here in the chest. She also hit him with a candlestick, and I knocked him around a little bit. He's hurting for certain.
Okay. Hank, there is something. It's not so much what he said, it's just something I know, okay?
All right, sure, whatever.
He's not far away. He said that he has a lot of scores to settle. And he's not going to go away until he does it.
All right, look, Nora. Now, I know you're not going to like this. But I'm going to put a guard on you around the clock.
Well, good, It'll be two of us then, because I'm not leaving her side.
Bo, you've got business to attend to.
Look, the next time Todd Manning gets away from me, he's going to be in a body bag.
You don't know.
Wednesday.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.